Hello, my name is Dr. Holly Bewlay. Welcome to Buffalo State's second opera production, sung by the students. This is an unconducted chamber experience for singers with focus on voice acting. I remember hearing stories on the radio or reading a picture book to my children, changing voices to make the characters and stories to come alive. Gian, Carlo, Menotti at age 23 musically told the story about how boredom and loneliness can cause a crime. Tonight's production will show you musical interpretation of the words by our singers, visual interpretation of the music by the art education students, and dramatic interpretation of the story by the film students. Please remember, this is a process-driven performance, and we hope you enjoy the product of what individual students learned throughout this semester. Thank you.
Late afternoon in Miss Todd's parlor. A visitor is just arriving.
Lemon or cream?
Cream, if you please.
40 years ago.
Look at him. Come in, good man.
beggar has no destination.
Haven't you a home or a vocation?
I have an ideal and we wander together.
In such weather.
I've never been a host, I've never been a guest. A man with an ideal has no place to rest.
Isn't it a shame? Isn't it a shame? Isn't it a shame? For I meant to invite you to stay overnight for some rest and a meal.
But I can accept all the same.
In spite of your ideal,
I betray it with delight.
Isn't he polite? What's your name?
Bob.
What a beautiful name. Well, Bob, come in the parlor.
Won't I soil the carpet?
Oh dear me, yes, you're all wet. Don't budge, don't move. Don't stir, hold your breath. Oh, you poor fellow, you'll catch your death. Take off your shoes. There, there. Take off your socks. There, there. Goat. There, there. Take off your shirt. There, there.
Take off.
Oh, dear. Just wait. Letitia, run upstairs and fetch that old bathrobe and slippers from my poor uncle Paul. I hope you're not too cold. Stand by the fire and make yourself at home while I make some tea.
Don't trouble yourself for me.
No trouble at all, the water is boiling in the kettle.
If it is so, I'll have some.
What a beautiful torso.
The next morning, Letitia and Miss Todd are chatting in the kitchen.
Why are you up so early?
I just couldn't sleep in. Is Bob awake?
I think he's still asleep.
Wasn't he so charming last night?
So charming.
And clever.
So clever.
And funny.
So funny. It really is so different with a man in the house. I will hate to see him go.
Yeah.
Don't you miss it? The energy in the air?
I do, but there's nothing I can do about it.
Why don't we ask him to stay with us?
Oh, I don't know. What will the neighbor say?
Don't you have any cousins? He could be one of them.
He doesn't look anything like me.
Second cousins? Fine. Just say that he's ill and no one will want to see him.
Do you think he'd agree to that?
I'm sure we can convince him. Good morning. I'm sorry I had to wake you.
It's fine. After sleeping on the ground for so long, this bed feels just incredible.
I brought you this.
Thank you. Do you mind if I eat it right here?
No, that's why I brought it here.
This is great. I promise I'll be out of here as soon as I finish.
About that, Miss Todd has been telling me that she's really sad to see you go.
It was nice meeting her, too.
We will play that scene one more time.
Why are you up so early?
I just couldn't sleep in. Is Bob awake?
I think he's still asleep.
Wasn't he so charming last night?
So charming.
And clever.
So clever.
And funny.
So funny. It really is so different with a man in the house. I will hate to see him go.
Yeah.
Don't you miss it? The energy in the air?
I do, but there's nothing I can do about it.
Why don't we ask him to stay with us?
Oh, I don't know. What will the neighbor say?
Don't you have any cousins? He could be one of them.
He doesn't look anything like me.
Second cousins? Fine. Just say that he's ill, and no one will want to see him.
Do you think he'd agree to that?
I'm sure we can convince him. Good morning. I'm sorry I had to wake you.
It's fine. After sleeping on the ground for so long, this bed feels just incredible.
I brought you this.
Thank you. Do you mind if I eat it right here?
No, that's why I brought it here.
This is great. I promise I'll be out of here as soon as I finish.
About that, Miss Todd has been telling me that she's really sad to see you go.
It was nice meeting her, too.
This is awkward. Miss Todd has been telling me, well, demanding me, to ask you if you would stay with us for another week or so.
For free?
I don't see why not.
Me neither!
But what if your thing, you know, how you don't like to stay in one place for too long?
My ideal? A smart man puts his life before his ideals.
If it's okay with you, you just have to pretend to be her sick cousin Steve.
That's fine by me. I wouldn't want anything different anyway. I'm not really planning on getting stuck with any women.
Do you mean you'll never marry? Not even someone like me?
I have to admit, you are very...
Letitia!
I'm very...
You're very...
Letitia!
I guess we'll have to wait.
I guess so.
Letitia!
Coming, Miss Todd!
A few minutes later, Miss Todd ventures out of the house to do some marketing. Down the block, whom does she see approaching but her friend, Miss Pinkerton?
Great beer, for he has seen no
and burly, hair black and curly, light complexion, southern inflection, and altogether handsome.
Tall and burly, hair black and curly, light complexion, southern inflection, and altogether.
Home quickly enough, for the similarity of Bob's appearance and the description Miss Pinkerton gave of the escaped criminal has given her plenty of cause for alarm. Into the front door she flies and into the parlor where Letitia is dusting.
Still here. Is anything missing?
Excuse me?
Miss Todd, is everything all right? Are you okay? Here, drink this. Now tell me what happened.
It's Bob. We have to get him out of the house tonight.
What? Why?
Well, I met with Miss Pinkerton today and she said that the thief from the town across the way escaped.
So?
He's tall, black hair, pale skinned.
I don't see what that... Oh my God!
What are we gonna do? Miss Pinkerton already thinks he's my cousin Steve.
Well, how should I know? Call the police.
The police? They'll think we've been harboring him here or something.
We'll just have to keep him here. I already asked him to stay with us another week.
Another week? He's a murderer!
He hasn't murdered us yet.
Just because he hasn't killed someone today doesn't mean he won't kill someone tomorrow.
But could you bear it?
Bear what?
You're the one who always tells me that you're lonely in this house without a man.
Well, if he's a murderer, then yes.
We'll just have to make him feel happy and secure.
Happy and secure? I'm broke!
Aren't you the leader of the Prohibition Society?
You want me to steal from the society?
No. Don't think of it as stealing. Think of it more as borrowing.
Borrowing? That is ridiculous!
You're just weak.
Weak? He's going to kill us!
Why are you so sure about that?
Because I just know it.
Everything is going to be just fine.
Letitia, I'm not going to steal for him.
It's not stealing, it's just borrowing.
Letitia, he's a murderer!
How do you know that for sure?
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Is everything okay? I heard shouting.
Just perfect.
Yes, everything's perfect.
All right then.
The days pass by. Bob remains a guest in Miss Todd's house. A week later, we find Letitia in the kitchen, taking pains mending, and then pressing a pair of well-worn trousers. Bob's, of course.
But he made no advances. Miss Todd schemes and labors to get him some money. She robs friends and neighbors, the club and the church. He takes all the money. With a smile that entrances, but still makes no advances. The old woman sighs and makes languid eyes.
A little later in the day, Miss Todd is sitting on her front porch when Miss Pinkerton rushes up the steps in breathless excitement.
Has someone had any breath?
must ask the police for protection. We must.
Suddenly, in complete silence, Letitia crosses the room, proudly carrying over her arms Bob's freshly pressed trousers. Miss Pinkerton stares open-mouthed while Letitia mounts the stairs and hands the trousers to Bob through the bedroom door opened to a crack.
Isn't the weather awful? Awful! Awful! But by the way, how is your cousin? Is he still so very, very ill? I'm afraid that he never will be very, very well.
You never can tell!
You never can tell.
Days go by. Miss Todd is sitting in her parlor. Letitia is in the kitchen getting ready to go upstairs with the customary morning tray so that Bob can have his breakfast in bed, as usual. Meanwhile, Bob, up in his room, prompted by a desire to take to the road again, is secretly making a bundle of his clothes.
When the air sings of summer, I must wander again. Sweet landlord is the sky, rich house is the plain, and to live is to wander through the sun and the rain. When the air sings of summer, I must wander again. First you wander in youth and joy, then you'll wander to still the fears in an old heart. First you wander to find your love, then you'll wander to hide your tears, for a wanderer must depart. When a man owns a house, he is a bird in a cage, whose captivity pays is sweetened with age. Ah, the sharp joy of freedom is my loss and my gain. When the air sings of summer, I must wander. Of you. Here I have nothing to do from morning till night. I don't read, I don't write, I don't work, I don't think. If at least I could have...
What?
Well, just something to drink.
My dear, do you mean liquor? Miss Todd! Miss Todd! Don't shout that way! But then it's go away if we don't buy him liquor! Liquor! Has he no pity? I who direct the Prohibition Committee, I who founded the anti-booze. No, no, I must refuse, I must refuse. Has he no pity? I must refuse. For me, he has no use. His brazen request might be only an excuse to put your love to the test. Could it be true? Could love be so exacting? That I can't possibly handle without causing a scandal. Shall we then lose our guest? What else can you suggest? Is drinking a sin? Yes. Is stealing a sin? Yes. Sinning against a sin can be no sin. Do you mean raid the liquor store? Yes, but how? We'll break in from the window and out from the door.
That sounds risky.
Are you afraid?
Not ashamed.
The village is sleeping quietly. In front of the liquor store, all is deserted, but down the block, two stealthy figures are approaching.
Thank you.
same sin. From this it's plain that most people's stomachs have more imagination than most people's brains. Virtue is mighty, but sin has variety. I hear them voice. That's just part of the orchestration.
It isn't.
It is.
Don't raise your voice.
Let's make our choice. There are some bottles of gin. You hold the basket while I put them in. Let me do it. Careful. Careful, careful. Somebody's coming. Hold on to your bottles and let us run.
Let us run.
The next morning, Miss Todd is in her parlor when the door burst open.
Miss Todd! Miss Todd! Miss Pinkerton, won't you sit down?
Have you read? Have you read?
The whole town is in an uproar, for last night someone prayed at the liquor store. The owner roused out of bed.
What shall we say?
Miss Todd. Hurry, Letitia. There is no time to lose. Out of the parlor, up the stairs to Bob's room. But they find the door closed.
Knock at the door. No answer. Knock again. Let us go in.
Trust my legs.
You must at any cost.
My body is like a feather. My head is full of lead. How can I?
Please pull yourself together.
I'll try.
You must at any cost. Your life is in danger. Your life is in danger.
What? In danger?
Yes, it is.
And why?
Because of the police.
Police? What have I done?
Stop acting my son! Stop looking dumb! We know who you are, and whence you come, and whence you run.
Gin was strong. Let's discuss it later on.
What's the matter? What is there to discuss? We have no time. You must confide in me. We are substitutes. Make yourself a substitute.
Let me get this straight. Did you say you stole?
Yes. Yes.
Shame on you.
Well, after all, aren't you yourself a thief?
Who?
You!
Me?
Aren't you the man who robbed and killed and raped and finally escaped from the county jail of Timberville about a week ago?
Heavens, no!
For goodness sake, who are you then, if not a thief?
I'm a beggar and a dreamer and a lost wind-tossed leaf.
And whence you come, if not from jail?
From the wandering of my trail.
But you still have one thing to explain. Why did you take the money we left around for you?
Because you made it plain I was expected to. Why should I have had qualms? A beggar lives on alms.
There is no more doubt. 'Twas a fatal mistake. And our lives and our honor are at stake.
But what have you done?
To get you some money, we robbed almost everyone. Miss Paxson, Miss Chaddy, Miss Jackson, Miss Manning, and raided a store.
You raided a store?
We raided a store. But now, don't you worry, I won't let you down. I'll stand by to defend you.
She's crazy.
Of course we must act in a hurry.
She's crazy. I've done nothing, have I?
So, is your love for me so small you won't stand by?
Small? I don't love you at all.
Ungrateful wretch. After all that I have done for you, you would see me in prison.
As a matter of fact, I don't see any reason for keeping you out of it.
I'll make you feel sorry for this. I shall call the police. I shall accuse you of mercy, robbery, and rape. And who shall take heed of the tale that you tell? You come from nowhere. But who would dare suspect me of misdeed? My blood is a poison tongue. I'm respected as much as the mayor. I direct all the social affairs. I'm the chairman of every committee for hospitals, concerts, and fairs. So beware, my dear boy. So beware. For it would be a great pity if I were to send you to prison and see you condemned to the chair.
Nothing to fear, my conscience is clear. I'll tell them my tale, justice won't fail.
Oh, young man, you ask for your doom. Letitia, don't let him out of this room. I'll go and call the police.
Nice mess you've got me in.
But I would like to help you, Bob dear.
Go along. I've nothing to fear.
But that's where you're wrong. I can tell at a glance you have not got a chance. Every circumstance is against you.
That's the wrong point of view. What matters is my innocence. Is there any justice?
Justice, like every other symbol, has always been painted as sticky, but is very nimble. No winking at life, no dancing with death. She knows that her scales can be tipped by her breath. And it would be a great pity for mine, who's so young, to be electrocuted or hung.
Acknowledging guilt.
Why do you care as long as you're free?
Shall my conscience fail to prevail?
You're not built to wilt in jail.
My two legs won't take me far.
Miss Todd has a car.
Do you suggest that I run off with her?
No, 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 no. I suggest that you run off with me. I know where she keeps the key.
Peace.
Any minute may bring the police.
I don't know of whom to be afraid.
I can see your decision is
couldn't do what a woman can. Make a thief of an honest man. Yes, let's go.
Let's go.
But as long as I'm taking the blame, I'll live up to my fame and steal everything she possesses. You look there for her linen and her fur coat and her dresses.
You look there for her money, rings, and necklace.
Don't forget to take the silver that is on the mantelpiece.
Don't forget the trap and clock, the bedroom candlestick.
Any minutes may bring the police. Quick, 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 quick.
A few minutes later, Miss Todd returns to her house. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is the final scene.
Thank you.